What's up, what's up, what's up, Facebook? You know what day it is. Today is Tuesday. And you guys know what goes down here on Tuesday. Wife chat goes down here on Tuesday. So do me a favor. Start telling all my one sexy wives that wife chat is going down here on Facebook. And I am so excited about the topic. Thank you guys so much for joining me. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Make sure that you're hitting the share button and letting all my one sexy wives know that wife chat is going down. Thank you guys so much for the love. Just make sure that you're hitting the share button and letting everybody know that wife chat is going down. It is Tuesday and I am excited. Yes. So thank you guys for hopping on. Thank you for hitting the share button. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Tonight I want to continue with some of my one sexy wives questions that I got from my list. As you guys know, last week I kind of deferred from them because I wanted to take on Pastor David and his shenanigans. And so I'm back and I want to finish answering some of the questions. I was going to answer three questions tonight, but I'm going to focus in on one because one is I got multiple people who are dealing with a spouse that they feel that is a narcissist or displays narcissistic behavior. So we're going to talk about that tonight. So make sure that you're hitting the share button. Make sure that you are telling everybody that you know that has a ring on that we're going to be dealing with a topic tonight. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Thank you guys so much for your comments. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for joining me. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I appreciate you guys for hopping on and I appreciate you guys for hitting the share button. A few things. On Saturday, I will be holding my second free virtual wife summit, right? It's called Becoming the One Sexy Wife. And I'm really going to pour in to you guys in my private group, just letting you know that I understand what it is to be a wife. And I'm going to give you some tools and strategies, literally, that I have learned over the 31 years of being married. I've been married most of my life. And I've been on the verge of divorce twice. We done dealt with so many different things, and I'm going to reveal a lot of those different things. It's going to be in my private group, and so it's a free thing. You just have to register for it. I've been advertising it, and I'll advertise it again tomorrow. You just have to sign up for it. Join the One Sexy Wife group, and I'm going to be doing some giveaways. It's going to be fun. It's going to be just like a conference, but you'll just be in the comfort of your own home, and I will too. So thank you guys again for joining me. Thank you so much for hitting the share button. Good afternoon to everybody. I thank you guys so much. And so I hope you guys will be joining me on Saturday. It's from 10 a.m. Eastern Standard Time till 2. You don't want to miss it because, again, I have a lot of good giveaways. We have some fun things planned for you guys. Even though it's a virtual conference, it's going to be amazing. And I'm going to give away a complete conference package to my One Sexy Wife Roundup for January, so you don't want to miss that as well. And so, again, I'm excited about the topic tonight. I want to answer one question that came from a young lady in Canada that joins me here in Wife Chat. Her question to me first before I get into being married to a narcissist is her question to me is, Gail, why do you always film your wife chats in your bed? You have a lovely bed, but why are you always in your bed? Let me just tell you this. I am not bed bound. I started doing wife chat at the in 2017. And I started doing it from my bed because I was bed bound because I was in a really bad car accident and my hip was out of socket and I had to have surgery and I've had two surgeries and that kind of thing. So I started wife chat because I was literally lonely, right? And I wanted to reach out to other wives and stuff like that because I couldn't physically get out and go hold my conferences and all my workshops and all the stuff that I do throughout the year. So I started doing wife chat to connect with you guys. And once I became mobile again and I started doing wife chat from my office, I got like inundated. Gail, why aren't you in your bed? How come you're not in your bed? So I went back to doing wife chat in my bed because I'm comfortable. I get a chance to pour into you guys. It's like me and my girlfriends sitting here just having a conversation. So to answer your question, the reason why I do wife chat, and yes, my bed has become famous, is because it started off where I was not mobile and I wanted to connect with wives around the world. And when I tried to go back and do it in my office, everybody was asking me why I was not in my bed. So the reason why I'm in my bed is because I'm comfortable. I get a chance to pour into you guys. And so that's the answer to my friend at all the way in Canada. Okay, so this wife chat actually comes from a wife all the way in Las Vegas, Nevada. And she needed help. She's like, "Help, Gail, I am truly married to a narcissist. And how do I deal with that?" And some of you are probably saying, "What is a narcissist?" So I'm gonna give you the definition. And again, I have two more questions that I'm gonna address next week for wife chat, and then I will go back to the normal stuff. But I wanted to make sure that I got on here. Thank you guys so much for joining me. Thank you so much for hitting the share button. And thank you so much for all your feedback from last week. I thank you guys. Some people came for me. At least they didn't come for me on the timeline. They came for me in, you know, in my personal inbox, which I can handle about, you know, Pastor Wilson and, you know, all his stuff. I did get some hits just to answer some of your questions from some people who said that they could put the first lady in contact with me. So I'm grateful for you guys sending me that information. And so again, let me get started. Let me give you the definition of a narcissist, okay? Because sometimes people always really don't know the definition of a narcissist and what is a narcissist. And you could be a narcissist or your spouse could be a narcissist. And I'm not going to be able to, again, address every single thing that has to come with being a narcissist. I am a licensed counselor. I am a licensed and certified Christian life coach and marriage coach and sexologist. I got all of these credentials. I am not a psychotherapist. I'm not in any of those things, okay? So I just want to give you this disclaimer. But let me just tell you this, how to deal with a narcissistic spouse. And I put spouse because women and men can be a narcissist, okay? And even if you don't walk in these traits fully, you can have some of those traits and you need to check yourself because it can really be irritating. It can be very difficult to deal with a person that's a narcissist. Let me give you the definition. Being a narcissist is a mental disorder in which people have an inflated sense of their own importance, a deep need for attention, and a lack of respect for others. This is a pattern of thinking and behavior. It is not necessarily a person. Again, it's a pattern of thinking and it's a pattern of behavior. It's not necessarily the person, okay? Let me give you some symptoms of being a narcissist. Exaggerated sense of self-importance. If you think you're all that in a bag of chips and that you are the most important thing that ever hit the planet, that's a sign of a narcissist. A sense of entitlement to money, time, and people. You know, you have met people that think that, you know, they're everything. You know, they know about all the money. They need to take care of all the money. They, you know, they take up people's time. They have to have the end with everybody else. They have a sense of entitlement to money, time, and people, right? They expect recognition and be superior to everybody, even when they don't deserve recognition. They are preoccupied with success, power, beauty, brilliance. They are just always obsessed of being in power, being in control, making sure that everybody knows that they did something. All of these traits are traits of a narcissist, okay? And they don't always walk in all of these different things. But if they tend to always have to talk about their success, talk about the power that they possess, talk about how beautiful they are. Look at me, look at me, look how smart I am. I came up with all of these ideas. Your ideas don't measure up to mine. All of those different kind of things is traits of a narcissistic behavior. They always constantly taking over conversations. They always want to one up. So if you went to Europe, they viewed the whole entire planet. They didn't been to the whole entire planet. You say you went to the Bahamas, they went to the Bahamas seven times and stayed in the penthouse if you just stayed in the bungalow. Whatever it is, they always have to, you know, take over and be in charge. They look down on other people who they perceive are beneath them. They take advantage of others to get what they want. They never accept the blame for absolutely anything. They do not apologize. They find ways to work around it to make you think that they apologize, but they never ever utter the words, "I am sorry." They do not like to accept criticism at all. And they do not like for you to confront them on any issues. So if you're dealing or if you display any of these traits on a continual basis, and a lot of times if you are a narcissist, you won't identify with any of them because you are the narcissist, right? But if you know that you display and you walk in any of these traits on a continuous basis, I tell you that you need to get help because it's literally driving your spouse and the people around you nuts, okay? And so what I want to do is really give you or give this lady and give the people who are here some tools and strategies that can really help you deal with a person who's a narcissist. Let me just tell you, you will never win with them, right? You will never win with them. So I'm going to give you some coping skills that have been known to work, right? And sometimes you're going to just have to, when I say walk away, I mean walk away and just say, I can't win with this. Okay. So the first thing that you need to do to be able to deal with a narcissist is really learn to pick your battles, because they're always on defense. They're always looking for a fight. They're always looking to win. That is part of the narcissistic traits. So you're going to have to learn to pick your battles, okay? And because they're always willing, and they can never see other people's sides of things. They're never going to be able to see your side of things. So you're going to have to pick your battles, okay? And when I say pick your battles, I mean not become a doormat and not just let them run over you. And that's, I'm going to give you the second thing, but make sure that you pick your battles. Everything does not have to end up in an argument if you're dealing with a narcissistic personality. The second thing is you're going to have to set boundaries, and not boundaries that you verbally tell them, but boundaries that you write. And what do I mean by write them down? Because when you're dealing with a person who's a narcissist, they don't listen. It's all about them. They want you to hear what they have to say. They're always right. So when you're dealing with a narcissist, you have to write down your boundaries. Listen, this is what happens when we argue in front of the children. This is what happens when you say these things to me. This is what happens, whatever. So they can see it. So when they step outside of the boundaries that you have written down, I don't tell you to do it verbally because they're not going to process. Write it down. And whenever they're stepping out of that and it's making you feel a certain way, you need to lead them back to the boundaries that you set, and you need to stick to them and say, until you correct this behavior, we can't have a conversation. Because you can't exist. There are many marriages that are thriving with narcissists, but they had to learn the tools and strategies in order to deal with that personality. And I say, do not, I know people say, well, yeah, I've had a conversation with, they didn't listen to you. Because again, they got to be the center of the attention. They have to have the power. They have to have all those things. That's why I say write it down. Put it somewhere that where they can see it and somewhere where you can always take them back to them. Take it back to them, okay? Don't take their behavior personally. Because literally, remember, this is a disorder. Don't take this behavior personally. I'm not saying be a doormat and let them just talk to you crazy or anything like that. You have to set the boundaries and say, listen, you're not going to talk to me like I'm your child. You're not going to do any of these things. Call me out my name. You ain't always got to be the center of attention. You don't always have to cut me off. Let me finish and then I will listen to what you have to say. Okay, so you have to set those boundaries and you have to be strong in them and you have to know your worth. When you're dealing with a narcissist, you cannot have low self-esteem because they will run all over you like it just bulldoze you over. And you've seen those people and you're probably dealing with those people or you could be one of those people yourself. Okay, so just make sure that you don't take it personal. Because they have a disorder and it's a diagnosable disorder and they can be fixed if you can get them some help. That's the next thing. Try to see if they will go see a therapist. Because most people who deal with narcissistic personalities, only 2 out of 10 literally seek professional help. Because again, they think nothing is wrong with them. They think they have healthy egos. They think you're the problem. And I'm just saying you, it could be anybody else in your circle. It could be the kids. It could be your friends. It could be anybody around them. They just feel that they have a healthy self-esteem and people can't measure up to their self-esteem. That's really what that's about. It's really about control. Okay. I said seek professional help because it is people who are out there and therapists that can deal with narcissistic personalities and they know how to diagnose it. You can't give them pills and stuff like that, but you can give them tools and strategies to understand how they're making other people around them feel, right? Like I said, only 2 out of 10 statistics say that people get help. I will tell you that most men carry or act or display narcissistic personalities, and it's because of the childhood that they had for the most part, that they have to win, they have to be in charge, they have to be seen, they have to be heard, all of those things. But women can display this as well, but the trait mainly lies within men, okay? The next thing is, if you really want to learn to deal with a narcissistic personality, you have to learn to flatter their ego. And what do I mean? If you need your husband to take your car to get the oil change, then you probably gonna have to say, honey, I just thank you so much that you, take care of the cars. You make sure everything that we're, you know, me and the kids are in a safe car. I truly appreciate you. I made an appointment for the car to get the oil change. If you don't mind, can you take it? Not be fake, but again, they thrive off of being in charge. They thrive off of flattery. They thrive off of compliments. So that's a way to get them to move in the direction that you need them to move with. And I know some people are going to say, well, Gail, I don't want to be flattering him. I don't want to be whatever. But again, it's just learning how to communicate with somebody that has a disorder, right? And you don't want to just throw the marriage away because he is displaying or she is displaying this behavior. But again, you can lead more bees to honey than you can with crap. And you know the other word that I could say. And so you're going to just have to learn to communicate with them. And you're going to have to learn to set boundaries that you both can live with. Write them down so they can see them. And they know that they can't run all over you with their behavior. Because they also can display very intimidating behavior. And if you are not secure in who you are, and you're not secure with what you bring to the table, they can literally shut you down and you could be very miserable in this marriage. Okay. Number 6, You have to be secure in who you are, and you have to demand respect in the relationship. And sometimes I know this is hard, especially if you have allowed this person just to run over you, and you just like tired of dealing with it, and you're just like, I'm just not gonna say nothing or whatever. The more you shut down, the more they're gonna rev up, right? And so the thing is for you, again, to get your perimeters in order and say, this is what I'm willing to tolerate, and these are the things I'm not willing to tolerate, and write them down. Again, they are not people that are going to listen to a whole entire conversation. So you're going to have to reach them through writing. And statistics say that when you're dealing with a narcissist, if you write it down, they will process the information much better than when you just give it to them verbally. I don't know why, but this is what statistics say, okay? And so my thing to you is, if you're the narcissist or if you're the person, try to see, get them some help. And if you can't, then learn how to communicate with them. Like they thrive on flattery. They thrive on you supporting them. They thrive on you, giving them accolades. So if you have to do that, not being, fake and, to your own detriment and all of those kind of things. But if that can work for you, like I said, using the car analogy, honey, I thank you so much for taking care of the cars, putting us in a safe environment, whatever that looks like for you, in order to get them to do what you need to them to do, that's a way to reach a person that is a narcissist, okay? And so my prayer is that this helps the young lady that reached out to me in Las Vegas, Nevada. Again, dealing with a narcissist is not an easy thing. It's not something that's going to you can get in control overnight, because it's a process. But I know that if you stay the course and that you get yourself some tools and some strategies, and if you can get yourself in some type of counseling, it will help you and your marriage go a long way. Okay. And again, as you guys know, I always go back on here. I always look at your questions. I answer your questions. If there's resources that you need, you can email me, you can inbox me, any of those things. Again, I'm praying to see all of you guys on the virtual conference on Saturday called Becoming. And then if you have not registered for the One Sexy Wife Roundup, I'm telling you, the slots is getting smaller. We're about to sell out. And I'm not even exaggerating with you. We are about to sell out of this conference. And I'm so grateful for all you ladies who have already registered. I'm adding some new stuff to it, so it's going to be hot. It's just going to be a great time. Again, I love you guys to pieces. I will be back on here answering any questions. I have a few more questions that I'm going to be answering from my email list. If you want to join my email list, my website is gailcrowder.com. You can download my free ebook called Mind Blowing Sex God Way, and it just talks about how to have mind-blowing sex with your spouse. And again, I love you guys to pieces. Thank you so much for sharing this video. Thank you so much for your emails. Thank you so much for your comments. I truly appreciate you guys. Have an amazing night. I will be on here answering any of your questions, any of your comments. I will always acknowledge them. And again, I thank you so much for being a part of my tribe. Have a wonderful, blessed night.